Welcome to Hit Points Gaming. My name is Corey, and in today's episode, I will be performing a Kickstarter preview for Eila and Something Shiny, published by Ice Makes. This game is going to be coming to Kickstarter on June 12th, and over the next few minutes, I will be walking through how the game is played, and based on my experience, why it will not hold a spot on my gaming shelf, but rather a perfect spot on my daughter's bookshelf between Wookiee the Chew and Mother Goose. Let's get started. So before jumping in and show you how the game is played, I wanted to give you an idea of how I approached this game and through what lens I was looking at this. So starting with the description of the game, it is a story-driven adventure game for one player, ages 7 and up, and lasts about 45 minutes. So luckily, I had a neighbor who was very interested in trying this game out. She recently just turned 6 years old, so I figured, let's give it a shot. Now, she doesn't have a lot of gaming experience, which is fine, which is perfect for where I think this game would come into play. So, you set it up by selecting a chapter. Now, this demo came with chapter 0, which was the prelude, and chapter 1. I'm not aware of how many chapters are going to be included in the game when it launches, but just so you know, obviously this is just a prototype. We started with chapter 0. What you're going to do is you're going to gather a set of cards for that chapter, lay it out on the board like this into a few different decks, and you've got a few different resources that you're going to manage. So orange is going to be for food, yellow is going to be for coins, purple is going to be for magic tokens. On the other side, another group of resources is going to be green for energy, gray is going to be for knowledge that you gather, and brown is going to be for fear, which is going to be a bad resource that you're going to have to deal with. So, not many rules in setting it up that I needed to explain to my playtester, but everything was right here, colorful. I really like the design here, I like the mat that it came with, and then we got started. So, what happens first is you're going to select the first card of your story out of the main deck and present it to her. So this one is Beautiful Nature. Basically, she gets to decide how she wants to experience this card, right? So first thing that I like to do, I like to pause and I asked her, what do you see on this card, right? There's obviously Eila right there. And, you know, show me what's happening. Do you like the art? She thought it was very cute. She noticed some of a few other creatures that were around. I said, hey, if you were in this position, what would you want to do? That's really what this is. It's the first story-driven adventure game for a child, is how I felt. You make a decision, right? So she can decide either to relax and enjoy the beautiful scenery or explore the forest. Now, depending on the choice that she selected, there's going to be an outcome. The top choice, she's going to be getting 3 energy, which gets placed on the board down here. Or, if she selected B, she's going to get 2 knowledge. Okay. Now, both of them are going to trigger card 11, which you'll see here, which comes from this deck, that's going to be placed into the future pile. All right. Then this card then goes to the past. You'll see here in another example where a card could come out again the following day, but this is going to be moved to the past. Now, what she's going to be trying to do throughout each day is gather a certain amount of resources that she's going to have to place at night on this card right here. Okay, so you're going to play through the game over the course of 7 days, meaning all these cards right here in this main deck are going to be played through, as well as any additional cards that you place into the future. So because she selected, you know, relaxing, a certain card is going to be placed here. Once I go through this entire deck, that's going to be the end of the day. At that point, she's going to have to spend 1 energy because, of course, you're tired throughout the day. You need to sleep. You need to spend energy. If you cannot do that, you lose 1 of your health tokens, okay? So once all of your health tokens runs out, you faint, or if you go past your 7 days, you've ran out of time. And that was easy enough to explain to her how you lose, and how I mentioned before, how you win is you need to gather these resources, and at the end of every day, you're allowed to place one or two of these resources up here on the board that's matching, right? Something that's pretty cool, there's things that you can do to gain energy, such as if you have two food, you can spend two food to get one energy, and it was easy enough to explain. Hey, what do you do when you're tired, or what do you have to do during the day? You need to eat. When you eat, you gain energy, right? So if she had a surplus of energy, food at the end of the day, she was telling me, well, I'll just eat two for one. So now we're starting to introduce some basic math, which is really cool. Certain cards, you can go around and purchase items. There's going to be items here that get introduced. It could be three gold to purchase one of these. This one here is a toolbox. And on certain cards, if you get a toolbox, maybe you'll be able to get more of a benefit. So it was really sharp to see a young child start to make decisions. Do I want to spend $3 to buy a toolbox? Well, what does that toolbox do, she says. I don't know. We're going to have to wait and find out. And eventually, that card came out, and it was very helpful to her. I really liked that right away, to see the gears start turning. Here's another card that I had to the side I wanted to show, which is this one right here. So here's another card that can be introduced. It's something simple. We're at a crossroad. What do you want to do? Turn left or right? There's not a lot of information here, but just to be able to see her say, I want to go left, okay? This card is then going to go into the future pile, so then tomorrow, maybe she wants to go right, or if left was a good decision, maybe she's going to do it again, right? The one thing I really wanted to point out to this game is when I'm playing games with my normal gaming group, sometimes it's hard to make a decision. I see a lot of people take a long time to come up with something, or they just can't. And I think that exists even outside of the gaming world, making a decision. And why is that? You know, we're always worried about consequence, or we're worried about the unknown. We're not sure. I think this is a way to start introducing those concepts to a young child right away, and they get to see how that unfolds and develops a story for them in a really sharp, artistic-looking, story-driven way. Now, the best part about this game, after I went through and I played it, the little girl said to me, so when can we play again? On my way out, she said, can you come back over tomorrow to play the next chapter? Absolutely. So that showed me right away that she was interested. Now, in order to get that, I needed to play along. I don't feel that a 6-year-old or 7-year-old could play this game by themselves. So yes, it is for one player, and I could absolutely play this by myself and go through it, and I know all the mechanics. I don't think a 7 or 8 or even a 9-year-old could really grasp the concepts and the mechanics of this card goes here, then you need to shuffle a deck, and this comes out. It's not difficult, but I don't think that's what it's meant for. I think it's meant for telling a story that they get to decide and they get to see what happens, right? That's where this game really, really shines. So I think if you are willing to put in that time and you want to experience a story with a child, this is exactly the right place to start. Now, some other things that I would like to point out. The first chapter, or chapter zero, was pretty quick. It was maybe about 20 minutes. Chapter one was a lot longer. There was a lot more resources that you need to get on this card. The first one, there was only two things that you needed. So she was able to breeze through this, get this knowledge, and it was good to go. Then when I showed her chapter one, wow, there's a lot more going on right here. So I did notice that about halfway through the game, there was things going on in the house, things that were distracting her. She started losing focus. So what I would suggest is breaking this game up, not into one session for one story. If you're playing with a younger kid, I would break it up into 20-minute intervals. Maybe you play 3 or 4 days before you go to sleep at night. I would make this become your bedtime story routine. something that the child's going to look forward to. Play for a little bit and then go to bed. As I was playing through, after I finished a chapter, I asked her, you know, tell me what happened. Who were some of the interesting characters that we met along the way? Oh, remember so-and-so did this and you got scared? Right. Well, how about tomorrow we avoid that person? Right? I think this is a really good way to start teaching those tips. The last thing that I would want to point out that I would want to see come out of the campaign are these, they're small little comic books, I would say. That's kind of what I'm calling them. That set up the story before you actually start that chapter. You go through here and you'll see that it's really, really neat. Little comic design of what's happening. I haven't seen any really words on here. Oh, that's the other thing too. You would need to be able to read pretty fluently in order to play this game. So again, that's why I think it's helpful for somebody to teach it and kind of be the explainer of the game to a child. But here's a small booklet that you get to start the game off. And then when you win the game or that chapter, you get an ending. Same thing, something happens, you go through this. And again, I would turn the page and I would ask her, you know, what's happening here? What do you think? Oh, this is happening because of so-and-so. Remember that person? Right. Really, really sharp idea. And she felt, oh, cool, I won. I get this book. Do I get to keep this book? Yes, you do. Bring it back, we'll play tomorrow, and maybe you can earn a new book. The one thing that I do want to see, though, is if the child loses, right? You lose all four of your health. It's tough to explain, oh, you lose. Well, what happens? I don't know. You don't get a book. I would like to see somehow if they incorporated, maybe in the same book, just maybe like upside down or in the back, maybe a few pages of what would happen when you lose. Maybe you get exhausted. Maybe you run out of food. Maybe you go back home. You know, the whole point is that Eila sees something shiny up on the mountain. Well, if I lose in chapter 3, maybe I turn back and I don't want to go up to the mountain. And it closes that story out, at least until tomorrow, for when I can attempt it again. But I think it would be a way for me to end the story for that night. What happened? Okay, now we can try again tomorrow. I don't want to be like, oh, well, game over, pack it up, time for bed. That might be a little bit too abrupt. So if I wanted to see one thing from this campaign, I would want to add just a few snippets of what happens if you end. Maybe in every chapter, that would be great, or at least something that I can explain to them. Or give me some sort of write-up that I would read every single time. That would be helpful. So that is my preview of Eila Something Shiny. It is coming to Kickstarter on June 12th. I am highly interested. I will be picking this up for myself, even though my daughter is only a few months old. I think that this is going to be perfect when she does get older and I can introduce her to all these other games that we have down here. We're going to be starting with Eila and Something Shiny. Thanks a lot for watching, and we will see you next time. And as promised, for completing both missions, Willow, you can have Eila and Something Shiny back to play it again and again. Thanks a lot for playing.